Dear students, today we'll start the properties of the amines, which will clearly differentiate between primary, second and tertiary amines. In the last class, we have seen the difference between primary, secondary and tertiary amines by giving the example of nitrous acid, that is action with nitrous acid, where the primary amines, they have the ability to form alcohols, primary alcohols. Second amines, they have the ability to form, that is nitroso amine, and tertiary amines, they have the ability to form salt. Today we'll see, just like that, we'll see one chemical reagent that is given, that should be given, and how that will distinguish between primary, second and tertiary amines. So next one, see, that is action. Action with, that is alkyl halide. Action with alkyl halide. What is the action of the alkyl halides with that of the amines? Primary amines, second amines and tertiary amines. But I am giving one example where primary, second and tertiary amine, all of them, how that react, that can be explained. For example, that is methyl chloride, CH3, so let us take Cl, methyl chloride, that reacts the primary amine, methyl amine, CH3NH2, that is the formula for that, methyl amine. And this reaction that may be treated as Hoffmann's ammonolysis, that is Hoffmann's ammonolysis. Action with alkyl halide, that is Hoffmann's ammonolysis. Alkyl halides that react with alkyl halide that react with primary amine. Alkyl halide that react with primary amine. This is the primary amine. So H and Cl that is removed, there is the formation of CH3O2NH+Cl. Again, alkyl halide that has been treated with CH3O2NH. So H and Cl that is removed, there is the formation of CH3O3N+Cl. CH3O3N+Cl. There is the formation of that tertiary amine. Again, CH3Cl that has been treated with CH3O3N, that is methyl chloride that has been treated with tertiary amine. What will be the product? There is the formation of CH3O4N+Cl-. There is the formation of quaternary ammonium salt. Quaternary ammonium salt, tetramethyl ammonium chloride. The name of this compound, tetramethyl ammonium tetramethyl ammonium chloride. So there is the formation of this compound, tetramethyl ammonium chloride. So, how to distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary amines by taking this example, that by the Hoffmann's ammonolysis, or that is action of that of the alkyl halide. If we'll start, this is the formula for that primary amine. This is your secondary amine. This is your tertiary amine. So, if we'll start from that primary amine, to obtain that quaternary ammonium salt, that tetramethyl ammonium chloride, quaternary ammonium salt, how many number of alkyl halides are required? 3. Primary amine reacts with one molecule of alkyl halide to form secondary. Secondary reacts with another molecule of alkyl halide to form tertiary. Tertiary that reacts with another molecule of alkyl halide to form quaternary. So quaternary ammonium salt, will be obtained. Quaternary ammonium salt will be obtained by the action of, that is, alkyl halide, 3 alkyl halides by the primary amine. So if we start from that primary amine, if we start from that primary amine, three molecules of alkylalide that is required to form quaternary. If we start from that secondary, only two molecules of alkylalide that is required to form that quaternary. If we start from that tertiary, only one molecule of alkylalide that is required to obtain the, that is quaternary ammonium salt. So how to distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary amines by the help of that Hoffman's ammonolysis, that is action with that of the alkyl halide. So whenever primary amines is converted to quaternary, that the requirement of three alkyl halides. Whenever that the conversion of secondary to quaternary, then two molecules of alkyl halide that is required. When tertiary amine that is converted into quaternary, only one molecule of alkyl halide that is required. So this reaction that clearly distinguishes between primary amine, secondary amine and tertiary amine, which I have cited in this example. So if we start from that primary amine to obtain that quaternary, three molecules of alkyl halide that is required. If we start from that second amine, two molecules of alkyl halide that is required to obtain that quaternary. And if we start from that tertiary amine, then only one molecule of alkyl halide that is required to get that quaternary ammonium salt. So this reaction that clearly distinguishes between primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Next reaction to distinguish between, that is primary amine, second amine and tertiary amine, that is action with, next one, that is action with acid chlorides. Action with acid chlorides. Next reaction of that primary, second and tertiary amines with that of the acid chlorides. That is having the formula acid chloride RCOCl. Then what will be the product that will form? We have to give the examples of primary, second and tertiary amines with that of this acid chloride. What are these different products? We will analyze. So the first one, that is with primary amine, that is action of the acid chlorides with primary amine. So there is the formation of, what is the product? N alkyl alkana amide will be formed. There is the formation of N-alkyl alkanamide means when primary amines react with acid chlorides, there is the formation of N-alkyl alkanamide. N-alkyl alkanamide will be formed. So we'll see by giving suitable examples. For example, that is acid chloride CH3COCl, that is acetyl. Acetyl chloride that has been treated primary amine, methyl amine, CH3NH2. So Cl part and H part that is removed in the form of that HCl. Acetyl chloride CH3COCl that has been reacted with methyl amine CHNH2. H part and Cl part that is removed in the form of that HCl. So what is this other products they will combine? What is that other product? That is other reactive space that is left. CH3CONHCH3. Cl part and H part that is removed at HCl. So the reactant that is remains CH3CO part, remaining part CH3NH2. So there is the formation of CH3CONH, that is CH3. H part and Cl part that is removed in the form of that HCl. H part and CL part that removed in the form of that is CL, that is the permission of CH3CO. CH3CO, NHCH3. There is the formation of that compound. And this compound, how to name this compound? How to name this compound? CH3CO, NH, CH3 plus HCl. How to name this compound? If this group is not there, then that is CH3CO, NH2. That is acetamide by ethanamide. RCONH2 form. If this group is not there, then it will be C, that is H2O, that is CH3CONH2, that is ethanamide, alkanamide, that is ethanamide. So from that ethanamide, this from this nitrogen atom, the hydrogen atom is replaced, one hydrogen atom that is replaced by, that is methyl. Mark it. How to name this compound? Students are doing mistake in this naming. How to name this compound? Let us consider this group is not there. Therefore, this will be treated as NH2. If this group is not there, then that is CH3CONH2. That is RCONH2. That is alkanamide, ethanamide. So, from this ethanamide, from this nitrogen atom, hydrogen atom that is replaced by, that hydrogen atom is replaced by that methyl group, then that is named as N-methyl ethanamide. This compound that is named as N-methyl ethanamide. N-methyl ethanamide. How to name this compound? This is very important. Students are doing mistake in this naming. H part and CL part that is removed as HCl. Remaining part CH3CO, remaining part NHCH3. After combination, if this group is not there, mark it. Then that is named as CH3CONH2. That is RCONH2. That is alkanamide, ethanamide. So from this ethanamide, the hydrogen atom from that nitrogen, that is replaced by that methyl. Therefore, that is named as N-methyl ethanamide. That is N-alkyl alkanamide. N-alkyl alkanamide, since we have given particular example, that is N-methyl ethanamide. So next one, this is the action with the primary amine. There is the formation of N-alkyl alkanamide. Second one, with secondary amine, how that acid chloride that reacts with secondary amine. So there is the formation of N-N-dialkyl alkanamide. There is a formation of N-N-dialkyl alkanamide. So if we take the examples of this kind, that is CH3COCl, acid chloride, that reacts with secondary amine. This is a secondary amine. Two hydrogen atoms of that ammonia that is replaced by that two alkyl group, that is two methyl group. So what will the product? The Cl part and H part that is removed as HCl. Remaining part CH3CO and CH3CH3. So there is the formation of this product CH3CO and CH3CH3 plus HCl. H and Cl that is removed as HCl. So the product is CH3CO, CH3CO, and CH3CH3. There is the formation of product that is similarly just like this one. Mardi, how to name this compound? Similar to this one, how to name this compound? If these two groups are not there, then this will be NH2. CH3CONH2, that is the formula for that. CH3CONH, so that is the formula for that. Alkanamide, that is ethanamide. CH3CONH2, that is ethanamide. From this ethanamide, two hydrogen atoms of that nitrogen, two hydrogen atoms from nitrogen atom that is replaced by that methyl group. So that is N methyl or NN dimethyl ethanamide. That is N methyl, NN dimethyl ethanamide. So the name of this compound NN dimethyl ethanamide. NN dimethyl ethanamide. So primary amines that react with the acid chloride to form N alkyl alkanamide. Second amine that react with the acid chloride to form NN dialkyl alkanamide. And how that next will explain how that tertiary amine that react. That is CH3COCl that has been treated with CH3 whole 3 N. Nitrogen atom that linked to 3 methyl group. CH3. So, since there is lack of that hydrogen atom, since there is no such hydrogen atom in this case, there is no such action. Mark the difference between primary and secondary and tertiary action towards the action towards that is acid chloride. Since the primary amine that contain hydrogen, NH group that contain hydrogen, that will react with the acid chloride. Secondary, again that contain hydrogen atom, that will react with the acid chloride. Since in case of tertiary amine, there is no such hydrogen atom attached direct link to that nitrogen atom, that will not react with the acid chloride. So, distinguish between primary, secondary and tertiary amines by the help of that is acid chloride. So, primary amines that react with acid chloride to form N alkyl alkanamide. Secondary amines that react with acid chloride to form NN dialkyl alkanamide. And tertiary amines not react with acid chloride to form any product. So this reaction that clearly distinguishes between primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Next one, that is action with Heisenberg's reagent. Action with Heisenberg's reagent, that is benzene, sulfonyl chloride. That is C6H5SO2Cl, benzene sulfonyl chloride. Next will explain regarding the properties of that amines, primary amines, secondary amines and tertiary amines by the help of that benzene sulfonyl chloride. This reaction that also differentiate between primary amine, second amine and tertiary amine, just like that is acid chloride. Then how that reaction that express, how that reaction that is taking place, we'll discuss one by one, action with primary, second and tertiary separately. So, primary amines, first one, that is primary amines, with one that is primary amines, that is reaction of the Heisenberg's reagent, that is benzene sulfonyl chloride. Heisenberg's reagent, that is benzene sulfonyl chloride with that of the primary amines. Then there is the formation of formation of एन अल्किल बेंजीन सल्फोनामाइड प्राइमरी अमीन्स रिएक्ट इंस्पर्स रिएजेंट और दैट इज बेंजीन सल्फोनिल क्लोराइड दैट इज C6H5SO2Cl टू फॉर्म एन अल्किल बेंजीन सल्फोनामाइड सो हाउ दैट रिएक्शन दैट एक्सप्रेस दैट इज प्राइमरी अमीन CH3NH2 that has been treated C6H5SO2Cl benzene sulfonyl chloride so H part and Cl part that is removed in the form of that HCl so there is the formation of this compound C6H5SO2NH that is CH3 plus HCl marked reaction this is your that is methylamine or you can take C2H5 that is ethylamine any type of primary amine that you can take methylamine just like this one I have given methylamine so that has been reacted with benzene sulfonyl chloride that reacts with benzene sulfonyl chloride C6H5SO2Cl so H part and Cl part that is removed in the form of HCl then what are these remaining parts C6H5SO2NHCH3 then how to name this compound if this group is not there then it will be treated as NH2 C6H5SO2NH2 that is benzene sulfonamide C6H5SO2NH2 then it is known as benzene sulfonamide so from this nitrogen atom one hydrogen atom that is replaced by methyl from that nitrogen atom one hydrogen atom that replaced by methyl therefore that is named as N methyl benzene sulfonamide so whenever primary amines that react with benzene sulfonyl chloride N-spurs reagent there the formation of N alkyl benzene sulfonamide that is N methyl benzene sulfonamide if you take C2H5 in this case then it will be N ethyl benzene sulfonamide in the second case with secondary amine that is formation of NN dialkyl benzene sulfonamide that is formation of NN dialkyl benzene sulfonamide so reaction of this secondary amines with that of the inverse reagent that is benzene sulfonyl chloride so we'll take the example CH3 that is NH that is a secondary amine that reacts with benzene sulfonyl chloride C6H5SO2Cl so H part and Cl part H part and CL part that is removed in the form of that HCl. Then what is the product? In part, C6H5SO2, C6H5SO2, N, CH3CH3. So the product will be C6H5SO2, N, CH3, plus HCl. After the removal of HCl, H and CL that is removed HCl, so C6H5SO2, N, CH3CH3. So this compound so formed, how to name it? If these groups are not there, then that is known as benzene sulfonamide, NH2, benzene sulfonamide. So from that benzene sulfonamide, the two hydrogen atoms that link to that nitrogen that is replaced by that methyl. So that is named as N methyl. Means NN dimethyl, benzene sulfonamide, NN dimethyl N-methyl, benzene, sulfonamide. N-methyl, benzene, sulfonamide. So that is the reaction that is taking place in case of that is secondary amine. So if we take the examples of that is tertiary amine. That tertiary amine CH3, N, there is no such hydrogen atom. Therefore, it has no ability to react with benzene sulfonyl chloride. No action. So, this is the primary amine. So first, we have to explain the action of the benzene sulfonyl chloride with primary amines. There the formation of N-alkyl benzene sulfonamide with that of the second amine to form N-dialkyl benzene sulfonamide. With that of the tertiary amine, there is no such action. So this reaction that clearly distinguishes between primary amine, second amine and tertiary amine. So, already we have explained regarding the three methods of differentiation between primary amine, second amine and tertiary amine. The first one, that is action with nitrous acid, primary amine will form alcohol, primary alcohol. Secondary will form nitrosoamine, which will respond for Lieberman's nitroso reaction, and tertiary will form salt. Next one, that is action with acid chloride. Primary will form N-alkyl alkanamide. Secondary will form N-dialkyl alkanamide. And tertiary will form no product. There is no such product. And if we take that is benzene sulfonyl chloride, that is action with benzene sulfonyl chloride. Then first primary will form that is N-alkyl benzene sulfonamide. Secondary will form N-dialkyl benzene sulfonamide. And tertiary has no action. And another method, that is Hofmann's bromamide or degradation reaction, that is Hofmann's ammonolysis. Hofmann's ammonolysis reaction. What is that reaction? Reaction of the amines with that of the alkyl halide. So if we start from that primary amine, three molecules of alkyl halide that is required to form quaternary ammonium. It will start from that secondary, two molecules of alkyl halide that is required to form quaternary ammonium salt. And if you start from alkyl halide, the tertiary alkyl halide, only one molecule of alkyl halide that is required to form, that is quaternary ammonium salt. So this is how we have differentiated between primary, secondary and tertiary amines. Next reaction, that is carbyl amine reaction. this is the reaction that is only shown by that is primary amines. Carbylamine reaction, that is the reaction that is only shown by primary amines. So whenever this primary amines RNH2, primary amine RNH2, primary amines that has been treated chloroform and KOH. So primary amines that has been treated with chloroform and KOH, they are the formation of alkyl isocyanide RNC, alkyl isocyanide, they are the formation of alkyl isocyanide. So this having foul smell, very disagreeable smell, that is having the foul smell, plus 3 KCl plus 3 water. So primary amines RNH2, primary amine, that is formula, that is RNH2. So primary amines that react with chloroform and KOH. Primary amine that reacts with chloroform and KOH, there is the formation of alkyl isocyanide, that is having foul smell. Alkyl isocyanide will form. So this compound that is only produced from that primary amine. No, neither the secondary nor the tertiary that respond for this test. For example, CH3NH2, that is primary amine, or we can take that is C2H5NH2, that is also primary amine, or we can take that is C6H5NH2, that is aniline, that is also primary amine, aromatic amine, primary amine. So all the examples of that primary amine. So methylamine, ethylamine or aniline that reacts with chloroform CHCl3 and KOH. Again this will react with chloroform CHCl3 and KOH. CHCl3 and KOH. Then what will be the product? Only this reaction that is shown by primary amines. That is only shown by primary amine. Neither the secondary nor the tertiary, they respond for that test. So whenever primary amines, that is methylamine, ethylamine, aniline, this is also primary amine, because one hydrogen atom of ammonia that is replaced by that aryl group, that is C6H5-phenyl group. So whenever the primary amine that reacts with chloroform and KOH, there is the formation of alkyl isocyanide, that is alkyl isocyanide, that is having very foul smell. This gas that has been generated in Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984, that is MIC, that is methyl isocyanide. So there is the formation of that CH3NC, methyl MIC, that is Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984. MIC, methyl isocyanide, plus 3 KCl plus 3 water, very foul smell, that is having very foul smell. And more than 10,000 people, they have been died in that Bhopal gas tragedy. So ethylamine that reacts with chloroform and that reacts with KOH, that the formation of C2H5NC, that is EIC, ethyl isocyanide, plus 3 KCl plus 3 water. So aniline that reacts with chloroform and KOH, that the formation of phenyl isocyanide C6H5N double bond C dirty bond plus 3 KCl plus 3 water. So this is the reaction that is only shown by primary amines, not by secondary, not by tertiary. So whenever primary amines that reacts with the chloroform in presence of KOH, there is the formation of alkyl isocyanide. So in this case, methylamine will form methyl isocyanide, this gas that has been liberated during Bhopal gas tragedy in 1984. Ethyl isocyanate and phenylamine, that is also, that is aromatic amine, that also respond for that carbylamine reaction, that the formation of phenyl isocyanate. So this is regarding some of these properties of that aliphatic amines. So today we have discussed regarding some properties which will clearly distinguish between primary, second and tertiary amines, and there are also some other properties we will discuss in the next class. So thank you all.